Hi, today I'm going to talk to you about a really cool, or rather hot topic. We're going to talk a little bit about urban heat islands. Now, this isn't the tropical vacation that you might have planned for, so you can throw those flip-flops out of the question for today. Today we're going to talk about what it means to be an urban heat island. Now, you may have been out to the country, maybe you've been to the forest, maybe you've been outside of a city. I'm gonna guess that there's probably a lot fewer parking lots, fewer buildings, less asphalt, cars, people. You'll probably run into a lot more trees or forests or farmland. So, in the city, we have all of these structures, like those buildings and those parking lots, that all reflect a lot of heat from the sun. So today we're going to do an experiment which shows how NASA satellites measure some of that reflected heat to tell us a little bit more about the difference between the heat in a city and the heat out in the countryside, which can impact how weather patterns in and around a city behave. And also tell us a lot about how much of the Earth is covered in developed area versus non-developed area, which can also impact our radiation budget, which is how much radiation from the sun is absorbed by the Earth or reflected by the Earth, as well as how much of the Earth reflects its own heat and gives off its own heat as well. So to do today's experiment, we are going to need an infrared thermometer, just like this. You can just order these online, maybe pick them up from a hardware store if you have one nearby, and you can go. So all we're gonna do is, it looks kind of like a squirt gun. All you have to do is push the trigger and point at different objects, and it'll tell you the temperature on the display on the back. So I have mine set to Fahrenheit, but you can also do degrees Celsius as well. All right, so I've set up a bright light over here. This is going to be my sun. This is a heat lamp. Now, this is one that you might use for raising chickens or other ways that they might be used to produce heat in an area, especially for some of those animals. But what I also have, in addition to that, is a house plant. A few different types of rocks, some water, some wet soil, and some dry soil. So I was just looking for a bunch of different materials that you might find outside because not a lot of sunlight from outside is absorbed inside. So we're going to recreate what happens outside in nature inside our house at home. So to do this experiment, I'm going to use my infrared thermometer and measure the heat that is being reflected from these different objects. So first, I'm going to start with some really dry dirt. So this was sitting in the sun here, or my make-believe sun, and I'm just going to point my thermometer at it and see what the temperature is. It looks to be about 76 degrees. So I know that my house is about 68 degrees right now. So 76 degrees is quite a bit warmer. Now, what happens when I do it with the wet soil? It's about 68 degrees. So it is actually room temperature, despite having sat here in my sun for a little while. I also have a rock, a very black basalt rock here that's been sitting there. And if I measure that one, we're looking at about 73 degrees. So this is a really dark surface. Now, what happens if I measure a very light surface rock? So I'll put this one in my sun as it's been sitting there for a little while and measure it. And this one indeed is a little bit cooler. It's about 72 degrees. So it's still warmer than the air around me because it's in direct line with that heat from my sun or my heat source here, my light. But it's still reflecting some heat, but not as much as the darker rock that's absorbing more of that heat, or the dark, dry soil. So this brings me to my water. So we saw that the wet soil was a lot cooler than my dry soil. So if I do the same experiment with my water here, my water temperature is about 68 degrees as well. So that might explain why that wet soil was about the same temperature as my water. Maybe it has something to do with the water or the heat capacity of water, which means how long it takes for something to change its heat when it's put in place of a heat source like that. And then plants. So I have an aloe plant here, the only plant I can grow indoors because my green thumb is not so great. I'll just go ahead and show you how this one works. And my plant is a little warm, but it's not as hot as my black rock. It was about 72 degrees. So it's definitely taking on some of the heat and reflecting some of it, but it's also creating its own method of cooling called evapotranspiration, where the plants actually create a cooler environment around them. So out in the country where there's lots of plants, we have a cooler weather, cooler temperatures. And in the city where we have a lot of dark asphalt or pavement, it's going to be a little bit hotter as those dark materials absorb so much of that heat from the sun. So using Globe and Globe Observer, you can go out and measure different temperatures in your neighborhood or on the land cover around you. One other thing I like to do with my kids is I'll let them use my infrared thermometer and have them run around taking temperatures of different objects themselves and recording them. We call it a heat-seeking scavenger hunt. So it's a fun way to teach kids about how different temperatures or how different objects have different temperatures and how they can go ahead and measure it as well, just kind of like a satellite would with remote sensing or a device that senses, not directly. So urban heat islands are a really cool concept, a pretty hot topic. And I hope that you enjoyed learning a little bit about the different temperatures of objects and how dark objects absorb heat and lighter objects reflect heat so that the temperatures are hotter for the darker objects and cooler for the lighter objects, and that plants actually create their own cooler temperatures with that evapotranspiration. Go ahead and if you have not already, download the Globe Observer app so that you can go ahead and take your own land cover measurements and help map out those urban areas, those forested areas, grasslands, and classify those different areas so that we can get more detail about what kind of land surface and land cover is on our earth. So I appreciate you guys tuning in today. Go ahead and keep taking those observations. Thanks.